Hello everyone, my name is Prod Silaos, also known as Prod. In this video I want to talk to you about BONGO, the media manager for Emacs. What I'm about to show you here is the set of extensions that I have defined for this package, which help me manage my local music collection. A few introductory notes before we proceed to the demo. BONGO has two types of buffers that help you manage your collection. The first one is called the library buffer and is where you hold all your media collection, so for example your music files. And the other one is called the playlist buffer, which is where you take files from the library and put them there to the playlist to be enqueued for playback. So what you have in the queue to be played. So this is the very basic idea. What you can do with it is you can make an arbitrary directory, in this case my music directory, this is dired, standard dired. You can make this a BONGO aware playlist. You can see over here that the minor mode BONGO library minor mode is enabled. So this gives me all the utilities that help me interface with BONGO while still retaining the functionality of dired. So this is absolutely fantastic. So the very first thing we want to see in terms of interfacing with BONGO is the ability to hop between the library and the playlist buffers. So you do that just with the letter H. You can see over here that this is the generic BONGO playlist. It just offers a comment with some notes here on how to use it at the very basic level. But below that you can see that there is no media file yet. So let's start adding some content. And what I'm about to show you here is almost in its entirety my extensions leveraging BONGO facilities and then a few extras that I have developed on my own. I will share the code, of course, more on that later. So let's add the directory at point. I just hit the return key. Let's control and return. And let's switch to the buffer over here. I paused the playback because we don't want to have any legal issues, but also because I don't want it to interfere with our presentation over here. We can see that the files have been enqueued, and we can also see that music has started playing over there. We can see the progress over there. Another thing to note is this thing over here, which is a custom, a bespoke section delimiter that I have introduced, which helps me manage what I call indivisible, what I consider indivisible sets of files that are designed to be played together. And I will show you this right away. Let's close the playlist for now. Let's say that I inserted this one on its own, but let's say that now I want a thematic, this thing, a thematic unit. So I want Bob Dylan, Eagles, and Eric Clapton to be considered part of the same theme. So I will just hit the key. You see, I am marking the items with dired, standard stuff, and then just hitting the key to insert them in the buffer. You can see very quickly that there are no delimiters between Eric Clapton and Eagles. Same for Eagles and Bob Dylan, but there is a delimiter between the previous artist, Alkinos, Ioannidis, doesn't really matter, and this thing over here at the end. So you can see that we have two sections over here. And the reason I have these is because it helps me add and remove content on block. So I can remove, for example, this thing in one go, and I can just focus on the rock hits that I have over here, and that's very helpful. And you can see that the rest of the buffer is empty. So that's the great thing about those sections. And the other thing about them is that it is a visual demarcation. So if I were, for example, let's come back here. If I were to add this as well, it doesn't really matter which one it is. You can see that I have a clear distinction. So I can browse this playlist and see what kind of interactions, sort of a history of interactions, what I removed and what I added in the process of playing back from my local media collection. So let's erase this buffer, let's terminate everything and close the buffer, let's kill it as well, it doesn't really matter right now, and let's focus a bit, we will return to the playlist buffer, but let's focus a bit on playlist files. So you can see that this directory is empty, and what I want to do is create a set of file system paths that should always be inserted as a block, that should always be considered part of the same group. Perhaps this is per genre or per theme. It is really up to you because there are no restrictions here. You are in charge. You define your own workflow, your own modalities of interaction. So let's say, for example, I want Eros Ramazzotti and Andrea Bozzelli to be part of a new playlist, let's say Italian. So I just have a prompt in the mini buffer and I type in some text, and I can see over here that I have already a new playlist. This is just plain text, no fancy file types, no special program to open them. This is just a set of paths, absolute file system paths to directories. And the reason I do this is because Bongo, the Bongo playlist, can accept those right away. So if I hit a key that I have defined, it will prompt me for completion for the playlists that I have. Because now I only have a single playlist, it's the only item on the list, but we will demo a bit later with a couple of more playlists. So I just hit that and it will insert it using the same principles that I described earlier, so with the sectioning of the block and things of that nature, and you can see how it is. So that's very helpful indeed. Let's now decide that, let's now see that I have another group, this group over here. So instead of marking it, I want the item at point. It works with diode marks, but also for the item at point. I'd want to add this band to the same playlist, so I am given a prompt and I can see, I can see right away that the file now has this this path as well. You can see it over here. So that's very helpful. Another thing that I have introduced is to check for duplicate lines and to also sort the lines accordingly, because it happens sometimes that I want to add a folder, a directory to the playlist, but I don't want to check whether it has already been added to that playlist or not. So, for example, if I try to add those again, it will not create duplicate entries. It will instead just make sure that I don't have any duplicates, and you can see how it is over here. Everything is sorted alphabetically and there are no duplicate lines in here, so that's very nice. Let's define some more playlists so that you can also see the completion. It doesn't really matter what it is now. Let's say, I don't know, relaxed. Let's have one like this. And let's also have, I don't know, let's have the rock as well. Let's have this over here as a rock. And you can see, by the way, that you are prompted for completion now. I could switch to a vertical layout if I needed to, but the idea is that now you have completion, so you can either create a new one or you can append to an existing collection, an existing playlist. So let's go back to our buffer over here. Let's empty everything. Let's delete everything. So let's now hit the key. You can see now that I have that I am prompted for completion, so I can just select what I want to select and have it play. Let's have rock. Let's insert it. You can see that I have it over here and it starts playing. Let's pause it. And you can see that I have it over here as I already described with the sections and things of that nature. Let's insert another item. Let's insert now relaxed. Let's go back. Let's go down and see. You can see that I have those as well and the sections and everything as already described. And at some point I want to delete the rock part. I can delete it and I keep this as well. This is very helpful, very simple, very effective. The same modes of interaction accessed through different means. One is from diode to the playlist and the other is from the playlist buffer, adding files. Essentially, this is just a file, so you can add a file which contains file system paths. So this is, in a sense, a file that behaves as a directory tree for the purposes of inserting media to Bongo's playlist buffer. So that's very helpful indeed. Let's come back here and let's start playing something. It doesn't really matter. I just want to show you. Oh, sorry. Let's have it like this. When Bongo goes over a track, this is customizable, of course, you can tell it to mark it in a specific way so that it will not go over it again until the buffer has no more items to play. So this is particularly helpful when you are in random playback mode, which is what I normally use, because you will not be playing the same track over and over and over. However, sometimes you want to just remove those marks, so it's a simple G, which is to generate the buffer, the list anew. So now you have removed all those marks and you can enjoy the same tracks over and over again. And similarly, I have another key, a simple key, which will toggle between progressive playback mode, which means the one item after the other, and random playback mode, which, as I said, is what I normally use. There are, of course, several key bindings for Bongo that you can always check with Control H M to get help for the major mode you are in. Of course, help commands are universal, so this is something you should always be doing with Emacs. So I will not walk you through the help over here. You can check these on your own, and you can always check my code as well, which, as I said, I will provide a link to in the description. Let's switch back here. So this is my .emacs. I have documentation, as always, on the matter at hand, and I also have the code block right below, so you can either go directly to the code, or if you need to read more about my rationale, you can also check the docs. And this is the code that I have over here. You can see there are quite a few things going on here, and at the very end I also define some key bindings. You can check those as well. So that's about it, folks. One last thing to bear in mind is that I am not sure whether Bongo can handle metadata. I believe it can, but I am not sure what needs to be done for it to do so, because my local media collection consists in large part of files that I extracted from older CDs. So I never really bothered with adding metadata to those. It is too cumbersome. But also, I do not really like metadata because I consider it opaque. Check this, for example. If you open this directory over here, you can tell from the file name alone who the artist is, let's actually switch to an English one, sorry about that. Let's switch to this one, for example. You can check. You can tell right away who the artist is, what the name of the album is, and what the name of the track is. I have removed all the numbers of the tracks and things of that nature. It doesn't make any difference in my life. I do not need them. I just need to know this information over here. And of course, when you insert, let's see, for example, let's insert those items in Bongo. When you insert those, already you can see that you have the indication in Bongo as well. You can see that they are marked differently. So it's really easy to go directly from the file name to this nice presentation over here, which is very easy to keep track of. So that's all I had to share, folks. I will provide a link, if you are watching this on the video hosting platform, I will provide a link in the description to my website where I will post this video. And below the video, I will embed the code, this part over here, so not the documentation as well. I will embed the code. If you want to check the documentation and the code as I will be updating it in the future, I will also add a link there to my .emacs. This file, by the way, is keep expanding in size. It is now almost 73,000 words long, so of course it's very comprehensive, and there is lots of stuff for you to find here, including everything I have demonstrated in earlier videos. You can check my backlog, which is quite long already for the past year or so. So that's all I had to share with you now, folks. This is BONGO, buffer-oriented media manager for Emacs, and all the extensions, the small-scale extensions that I have provided for it. That's all for now. Thank you very much for your attention. Goodbye, folks.